Got it. Oh, it is pitch friggin' black in here. Perfect. We love it. All right, so now the mob should spawn and be pushed off. What's up, people? I'm Zog, and welcome back to FTB Infinity Evolved Expert Mode Skyblock Place thing. Yeah, totally. No, we're gonna go with it. We're just, yeah, That's correct. Now, what we're doing is we're kind of preparing for something, because I think, would you, what? Go in the thing. Oh, I must have double-click stuff. We are preparing to do something we probably should have done a while ago. And that is, we're gonna make a mob farm. Now, I was taking a look at some of these spikes, right? And you would think, okay, wooden ones right now would be best, because then I can go over there, I can get experience anytime I want to, all this good stuff, right? And then you take a look at what you need for one wooden spike. Just one. You need magical wood, which means you need bookshelf and sugar cane. I mean, we could get all this stuff as far as this is concerned, but then you need an etheric sword? Are you kidding me? What? Why? They're just wooden spikes. But I guess the feature that it doesn't actually kill mobs is very, very handy. I guess that's why everybody uses these, and therefore they didn't want to make it easy for you. The golden ones, you're like, holy crap, oh, so you need an iron one, plus more magical wood? We could go that route. It could be a thing. Diamond is really, really, really good because of the fact this actually, basically, it pretends like you killed it. Like you killed the guy, right? Like it was killed by a player, basically. So that'd be pretty good for certain loot. In that case, so this makes sense that it's expensive, plus it's diamond, so of course, you know, diamond, you need diamond everything, and then a piece of gold anyway, so you need this anyway. But then you come to iron and you're like, oh, three blocks and three swords per one spike. That's not too incredibly terrible. It could be a lot worse. It could be a lot worse. But what we want to do is we want to be able to get everything from these guys, from these drops, everything that we can get. Naturally, we can't do the player kills just yet. We'll be working on these. Maybe we'll slowly upgrade to them and kind of replace the ones we have. And that way we can actually get some if one of the mobs just so happens to die from the diamond spike. That'd be pretty cool. We could every now and then get a player drop and we could slowly upgrade as we get there. But you get the idea. Now, what we want to start out with is actually 9 iron spikes. We want to start with 9 of these guys because the normal way to make a mob farm is to just kind of have it spawn and use dispensers and trigger them via redstone to use water to push them off the edge and all this other stuff, but there are problems with that. For example, we definitely want enderpearls. We want enderpearls like crazy. You have no idea. We would definitely want the enderpearls. But that means we can't use water to push them off because Endermen are allergic to water and will instantly teleport to the nearest available platform outside of the mob farm to get away from the water. We don't want them to ever teleport. So we don't ever want them to see us, and we don't ever want anything like that. If they are not triggered, meaning if we're not looking at them and we're not seeing anything, or they're not seeing anything, they won't teleport. So we have to use something else to push them off the edge, and we have to use something else to kill them, because water will not cut it unless we, you know, build out. It is a thing. I mean, you could do it. You could build out like you do in the end of the you know, Enderman farm and stuff. You just go out far enough and you're good to go, but we're not going to do that. We don't want it that far away. We're going to build it right over here. So what we're going to do to push these guys off the edge are fans. Now, fans are very, very handy. I like, don't put plural when you're looking for it in the NEI, Zog. Don't be a dummy. Fans are actually incredibly cheap. They are activated via redstone, which is pretty easy to get. It's not difficult. You might have to wait a little while to get enough of it or something, but, you know, it's fairly simple, you know? Oh, what? Glue? We're making a glue block, people. We're making a block of glue. Is that really a thing? Apparently it is. It wouldn't have let me do it if it wasn't. We have a block of glue. I don't know. I don't. All right, let's go ahead and melt you back down. Let's waste some of our lava. Anyway, so now that iron is selected, we can do that. So I'm basically melting. Oh, whoa, that was weird. It like glitched in and then out for a second. It kind of freaked me out. Yeah. Anyway, so we're going to use fans to push mobs off the edge. And we're also going to use these iron spikes to kill them. Now, that does mean we're going to lose some drops and stuff. When they spawn and everything, they'll fall, they'll die, and I'll lose a lot of drops. Hopefully it doesn't cause too big of a problem. But very shortly afterwards, after we start getting things, we're going to look into a vacuum hopper, which we can't get yet. We can't do this yet because we need the Eye of Ender. Which means we need an Ender Pearl. Now, these guys we have, we get that from sifting, but we don't have the Ender Pearls. So as soon as we kill the first Enderman, we're going to make one of these guys, and we're going to hook it up over there and deposit that into a chest, and we're going to upgrade that chest as much as we can, so that way we at least get a bunch of drops, and we just have to pay attention to clearing it out every now and then. So, yeah, that'll be a thing. But anyway, I did want to go ahead and mention that I have hit 2,000 subscribers. 2K subs, people. 2K subs. This is pretty good. This is good. I like this. This is amazing. It's awesome. Now, don't worry. This is not my sub special. This is a normal episode. My sub special is going to be ridiculously special. It's definitely a special. It's a special sub special. And what it is basically I have the people in the Discord chat along with a friend of mine. We're all, well, they, I'm not even involved in this. They are making a map for me to go through. And the object of this map is to kill me as many possible times, as many times as possible. I said that backwards. And that's pretty much the idea. It's like a gauntlet. I have to go through this thing. Now, I do have a few questions lined up, and I'm going to try to answer those questions as I go through this thing. You're going to see me die a lot of times. It's going to be wicked. It's going to be fun. It's going to be great. But it won't be up for a little while. So this gives us time to collect a bunch more questions. I need all the questions you can throw at me. Give me all of them. Anything you want to know about me, put them down there in the comments or tweet them at me or send me a message anywhere. That you know you can get a hold of me anywhere that you know I will read, send me a question. I will write it down and I will save it for that day when we actually end up going through this thing and, you know, hooking some stuff up, which is going to be really, really cool. It's going to be really, really fun, so you definitely should check it out. It's going to be more like a series. It's not really a sub special so much as it is... Why did you stop? So much as it is a sub series, like a special series. It's going to be, I don't know, it's more than likely going to be more than one video. It's going to be pretty cool. It's going to be a cool little thing. Hopefully it turns out really good. Hopefully these guys get it done fairly quick. You know, no rushing. You can't rush genius. So, you know, they got the time that they need. I'm gonna postpone the sub special for a little while until, you know, we actually get some stuff going for it. That way it is more entertaining for the people. And I have absolutely no idea what's going into this map. But I basically told them, I gave them one rule, only one. I said, do whatever you want to try and kill me. Make it as difficult as you want, as tricky as you want. I don't care. The only thing is it has to be passable. I have to be able to get through it without dying. Well, if I have to die and then I'm teleported to the finish line to continue the next part, like if dying is part of it, then yeah, I can kind of see that as being okay. I would prefer that it's possible if I don't have to die, but chances are I'm going to be dying hundreds of times, and I'm going to have a death counter on the screen and all that other good stuff. It's going to be a blast. And plus, the entire time, every episode of that series, I'm going to have a face cam on. So that's going to be a thing. Check it out. Well, I'm just a little bit disappointed in myself. How about you? Because I'm sure you noticed just like I did at some point. This is not how you make those spikes. You see, crafting table, QED, okay, QED, all right, QE friggin' D, really? Are you kidding me? Can you believe, what, oh man, now let's take a look at the QED. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Ender. Oh, really? Oh, Ender Pearl. Really? You need the Ender Pearl. Okay. Machine frame. Oh, Oh, yeah. All of this crazy, like, carpenter in this thing. And then the. Uh-huh. Yep. Nope. I'm not kidding. I'm not kidding. It's this difficult to get the friggin' QED. Oh my lordy, lordy, lordy. So what we gotta do is we gotta go even lower level, peeps. We're gonna do a mob farm that it's still not gonna involve a fall trap. I don't like the idea of a fall trap here. One, because I have to build up really, really, really high. And even though I could make it so I could one-shot all of them and all that good stuff, I don't know. Maybe. I don't... Is there something else that can kill or hurt mobs without making them teleport? Because we need the Ender Pearls. You know, this is very, very unfortunate. You know that? This is so highly unfortunate. Because if we don't do some kind of a fall trap, then the Endermen, as soon as I hit them, they might try to teleport. Now, I don't believe they teleport if you hit them at their feet. But I don't know. Okay, check this out. Monster Hunter, we got it. Attack and destroy a monster. We did that. We also did time to strike when we tried to make the iron swords for the spikes that were going to be amazing. And yeah. So anyway, this is our mob spawner right here. Now, it looks like it's open, but don't worry. No light can get into the middle of these. You see the red X? It means no light can enter and mobs can spawn at any time. So they are very, very small. I'm thinking I might extend them quite a bit further. Maybe not quite a bit, but like maybe double the size. And we're also going to repeat them. And now it's actually kind of easy to repeat them, actually. It's really not very difficult to do, just because I already have the first one set up. And basically, this is all we really got to do. Now, we want to get the top part first or else we're not going to be able to see it. That one's gone forever. It's gone forever. But we can just go ahead and extend these guys. I got to make sure I'm not going to fall off the cliff here because that is entirely a possibility. And then after I do that, I can bring this guy around just like so. And they're kind of right side by side. And it's very handy the way this is currently set up because... shift and thank you and give me thank you, because if we pay attention to how it's designed, give me a second after I get these guys set up. I gotta hold shift because I know I'm getting close to the edge ish kind of sort of maybe possibly. That's why you do the top first, stupid double clicks. But we have this right here, and I can easily walk in between them all in order to get to all of the mobs, and I can only see their feet. So Endermen shouldn't be able to teleport out, I hope. Now, if they do and they try to target me and chase me down, I might die a couple times because I currently don't have any armor. We need to remedy that pretty quick. But for now, we'll survive. We'll figure it out. We'll die probably, but it is what it is. I'm thinking they're going to be okay. So what I'm going to do is duplicate this a bunch. And what this will let me do is basically we'll have mobs. We won't have a huge amount of mobs. We won't be able to do a huge amount of stuff with them. But we can get them done, which is the basic idea with this. So maybe we'll be able to get started on some of the things that we do need Ender Pearls for. We'll be able to get going on things and it'll be okay. Okay, so here is our mob spawner. It's kind of going. I mean, it's okay, right? It's not absolutely terrible. I think these guys can actually see me if I'm like at an angle like this. So we got to be a little bit careful around the creepers, just because I do believe if we're not like directly beside them like this, they can actually see us and they can blow up. Like they can see us like that. And I don't know if they'd actually be able to blow up. I mean, I'm sure they'd be able to, but it's, you know, I don't know. Also, we did get a piece of armor. We're wearing a leather tunic now, which is pretty good. I also extended the back of this a little bit and we're good to go there. Now, the biggest thing that we're looking for are Endermen. We want the Ender Pearls because a lot of things require Ender Pearls, and we currently don't have any, and we need a way to get them. So I think what the problem is these guys right here are not as tall as they need to be, I think. So we gotta increase it a little bit. We gotta, you know, do some things in order to make this even higher. So I guess we'll go up a full layer just because right now they're on the bottom slab. So if we only raise it half, then these guys will also be spawnable. We'll have to, we'll start getting in some trouble unless we light it up. And I would rather use slabs than, you know, that kind of thing to do this with. Well, actually, you know what? Let's not do this. Let's skip a space first and then we'll do, yeah. I'm liking this idea a little bit better. We'll skip the blank space will be right here. So if we put a block down, then this is a bottom slab right here. So basically the next layer of these guys will be on the same level as these guys, which actually makes it a little bit easy for us because of that. But we need to get rid of you. And then the layer there will be, so we put here and then go here and then here. Just like so. So that way we actually have everything we need in order to make this work. We gotta get rid of this guy. And we go like this, like so, and then like here. Just like this. So this is gonna be a little bit of placing work and stuff. So I'm gonna go ahead and take care of this off camera real quick, and I'll see you back in a second. Nope, I've got this. I've got it. Okay, we finally got one. Let's see how this works. Yes! Oh man, did we get an ender pearl? We didn't. Okay, so let me show you what it is that I actually want to do. All right, because I want the QED. The QED is going to be good, and going to get the QED is going to give us a lot of the things if I can make it work. If I can get to it, it'll give us a lot of the machines that we really, really need in order to do a lot of this stuff. But let's take a little thing, inventory of what we're gonna need. Okay, we need one ender pearl here, and we need another one here. That gives us four, so we only need one for this. Then we have to go into this guy. We already have the thermionic fabricator. We'll need to give it powder. Power, but that's not a big deal. This guy will need to do some more assembly table things, which is going to take a little bit of time. We'll need to do another thermionic fabricator. So we have all of that stuff. This stuff can be made. Let's see, what do we need for you? We need destabilized redstone, which I think, I don't know if we can. I think we can put redstone into here in order to get it. You need 1,000 just to start the mixture. And that goes down to 576. So we actually need quite a bit of redstone. I'm not sure how much each one of these gives you. One redstone gives 100. So we need to put in 10 redstone in order to get one batch of signal amount. I don't know how much signal limit, how far that's going to go, basically, in this. But we only need 4 nuggets, so hopefully one batch will be enough. But after we get all this stuff, then we got to go back. And we need to, yeah, that was that. Okay, we did this, and we got the energetic alloy. We have to get an alloy smelter. So if we look up the alloy smelter, here we go. What do we need for this? We need some crushed obsidian, which I think you can use a hammer on obsidian. And I think it has to be a diamond hammer, but I think you can do that. I believe it doesn't actually show the hammer recipes in here, so that might be a thing. We'll have to check that out. An electric furnace, which redstone in this electronic circuit, we can make all that stuff. We've done that before. Another one of these guys. We need more signalum. We need two electric furnace. One of these guys, which is an electric furnace with copper stuff around it and an advanced machine casing. Yeah, we have to do a lot of stuff. But what the heck? A mixed metal ingot? That looks wicked. That's pretty cool, though. Iron plate, bronze plate, and tin plate. Yeah, we can do that. That's not a big deal. This is kind of crazy, peeps. This is really, really crazy. Raw carbon mesh, raw carbon fiber, pulverized coal. So we got to find a way to get this stuff. We'll do this the easiest way. Probably the hand crank, just so we can get enough to get what we need for this. So we'll do that times two. Basic machine casing with this. This is one heck of a rabbit hole, but this is the next rabbit hole we're going down. An alloy smelter is going to be invaluable for us. So we definitely want to get that. And that's going to be something we can add to, you know, the list of things that we can get or already have once we get that. And these guys are going to come in handy once we start getting some other Ender IO stuff as well. So, yeah. And then we need this guy, which is an assembly table in here. more crushed obsidian. We're going to need a carpenter to get this done. But other than that, it's not too expensive. This is 9 steel plates, but we do have the iron and we do have the fuel for the, what is it called? The smeltery thing, Imajig, over there. Enderium, we need more ender pearls. So we needed 2 before. If we take a look at the recipe, we need 1,000 of this in order to get 576. And each one of these gives 250. So we need 4 more ender pearls. So far, we're up to 6 ender pearls. Everything else is like, yeah, it'll take a long time to get this much power into it, but we can do it. That is the bottom line. We can do it. Then, if you think about it, we were looking at the QED. Now, quote erat demonstrandum. quad? Erat? I don't know. It's probably like Latin or something. Quadratic equation device. Nope. Look away. Quantum entanglement diviner. Look away. Quite elegant device. Yeah. So anyway, the QED needs something else in order to operate. It's called the Ender Flux. Or, no, what is it? I thought it was the Ender Flux. You know what? Let's just... Oh, that's because... Okay. Nope. We're fine. We're fine. I was typing in an at sign. We need this guy right here. The Ender Flux Crystal. More of this, which, again, that makes 7 Ender Pearls. We need this guy, which is an integration table. 25,000 RF. We can make that work if we can figure out and make sure we need that. But then you go to this guy, and you're like, okay, not a problem. Now, there was one of them in here. One of these guys was like 50 million... something's 50 million in the assembly table, like ridiculous amount of power, like crazy. We're gonna have to look at this guy to see the cheapest recipe, as well as actually it was one of these guys that I needed. Iron ore gate, that's only 200,000. That's not a problem. You 600,000. So you get the idea. We're gonna find the cheapest combination, but then we're gonna need the integration table. Okay, that's not actually that bad. That's really not. It could be a lot worse. But it looks like, you see there, it says Buildcraft, colon, silicon, colon, laser table block. Laser table. I think we're going to need lasers for these guys too. But I wonder if the other lasers will work for these as well. We can kind of trade them out and just kind of mix them up, place them side by side and such. So we're going to need a lot of stuff. But the first thing that we need are the Ender Pearls. Well, sometimes I don't always think of the best things to do. So we had to go through with just a little bit of a change. Here you go. Here is our new mob farm. It's changed a bunch. Hello, Skelly. Oh, that's perfect. All right, cool. Apparently, it's just enough of a fall to make my sword a one-shot. One-hit kill to, well, some of them at least. But anyway, so we're going inside now. Thank goodness there's no more mobs in here. I didn't even check first, but that's fine. What we have, you see all these guys right here, right? Yep. Okay, so what I want to do, we're going to go ahead and put this guy down, right? And then we're going to go ahead and lay out all of our fans. I probably should not have put him down yet, but we're not going to break it because I don't want to lose it. I think we have enough fans. And what we want to do is try to aim straight, because what'll happen if we aim diagonal, the fan will aim diagonal as well. And we don't want that. So we want it straight back. Now these guys push 8 blocks, but the 8th block is really, really slow. So if we look here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we have 7 blocks, which does in fact reduce the spawning spaces that we have. So... bam and bam. We just, oh, see, that one's a little bit diagonal and that's gonna bug me. So the reason I did this is because the other mob farm was just not working out very well. I'm not sure if I explained this or not. And it's just sometimes I can be a bit of a derp, you know. I didn't think I was sitting here kind of just thinking about it. I was like, okay, so we stopped because the QED was difficult, but the QED was only for the spikes, not for the fans. The fans still work. they still work just fine, and they're pretty simple to make. Now, these guys are not straight. I need to stop being so picky, because I really want to fix some of them. Yep, you're on. I get it. Yep, you're on. Okay, nope, nope, I see it. Okay, move over, and then right there. Okay, nope, we're fine. Okay, so these guys are not perfectly straight. I do understand this. All right, so we have one fan extra, which is, yeah, that's fine. Now, what's going to happen is we're going to get pushed back slowly, and then bloop. Now, all of them should be on. Let's make sure. Double check. They are. All right, so now what we can do is let it push us off the edge like it just did, and we can go ahead and do this, and then we can go ahead and close it back off, and we can go up top. Oh, I didn't remove my torches. Dang it. Crapo. We're going to have to let it push us off again. We got to get rid of all these torches. Nope. Break. Break. Thank you. Then we need to go over here. Oh, I say all these torches. There's only two. There's only two torches. And also we need to get the... Oh, I can't get the spot. I can't get it. Run, run, run. Oh, run. Sprint, sprint. Can we... Yes. I think we got it. We did it. We did. We got the thing. All right, let's see if we can patch these some of these holes while we are, in fact, down here. And I broke a few just so the daylight would prevent spawns while the wind ran back to get some supplies and stuff. Got it. Oh, it is pitch friggin' black in here. Perfect. We love it. All right, so now the mobs should spawn and be pushed off. We're going to go up top just to double check to make sure I didn't miss any spots where there is place missing or stuff missing. But I'm pretty sure we got all the holes, so we should be good to go. Yeah, we're good. We're good. So now it's time. Let's see about this spawnage. See if it happens and how well it works. Oh yeah, look at that, peeps. Look at all the mob spawning. We did, in fact, get a baby zombie in there. That's one thing that I was worried about. That was a decent little thing, but it seemed to have stopped a little bit. Oh, look at the spider guy climbing out of the way. You're gonna cause me problems, aren't you? Glad they're a little bit rare. We can let them just kind of despawn on their own. I think we even got a few witches in there. Not seeing any endermen just yet. There we go. Yeah, we're getting some stuff in there. We're getting some stuff. It seems like the babies are glitching out a little bit, but we're getting some mobs. I still don't see any endermen, though. We really, 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 really want the endermen. It's not absolutely terrible, though. I mean, it's a thing. I still need to get my ender pearls for sure. Wow, look at that batch. And now the spiders don't stand a chance. Well, they do stand a little bit of a chance because they can climb, but now they'll actually fall to the bottom and it'll kind of be a thing that way. But, you know, it'll be okay. It'll be all right. We do have some spiders and stuff. We'll get to them. They'll end up climbing and falling several times and dying that way. But for now, we do have this stuff. And now the problem that we're going to suffer is that the creepers, number one, the creepers... There's another crash for you. Yes, I did say another crash. Both of them seem to be around mob spawning, and I'm not sure exactly what's doing it. Oh yeah, darkness. You can't see very well. What I was saying was we have to worry about the creepers because now if they're on the back and we're on the front, they can see us and they will try to explode. As well as that, we also have the items that you see. I did clear out the back of this so we could actually get all the way around it in order to get all of the items. And I just kind of cleared the bottom of this out just because I think it looks cool. But yeah, I don't know. I mean, it's okay. It's not absolutely terrible. It's functional at least, right? So, yeah, go ahead. Badger me in the comments with all the... Yeah, this is stupid. It's a crappy one. It's so bad. Yeah. We're kind of limited in our choices as far as things go, you know? We can't really do a whole lot. So we're kind of stuck with that. But anyway, so that's about all the time I do have for this episode. I need to kind of... stay away from those spiders. One of the spiders fell down, and when I was like right underneath this thing, I did actually I got hit and bounced back a little bit. It almost knocked me off the edge, so now I'm a little bit freaked out about that. But just kind of scared me a little bit. So we're definitely extending this, but it's probably a good thing to do anyway, because we do have to come back here in order to get some of the items and stuff. So I'll end up taking care of that. I'll extend it out a little bit, maybe pretty it up, probably not though, and just kind of make it a little bit better if I can think of a way to do so. But we are looking for Endermen. I'm going to try to collect a few Ender Pearls. This is all the stuff we've gotten so far. 29 arrows, 40 bones. Oh, look, we got one of those things. Yeah, a couple heads. We're going to need some more storage for all this stuff. But you see that it is indeed working pretty well. It's not great, but it is decent. So we should be able to get some stuff from this. Hopefully we do get some Enderman spawns in there and we do actually get them without teleporting, and we can kill them and get their Ender Pearls and start on the QED process so we can get some spikes and automate it. Then we can work on getting an Ender Pearl to automate the collection, which I may do before the spike. Talking. But anyway, if you like the episode, don't forget to hit that like button. If you want to see more, you want my videos sent directly to you, then don't forget to subscribe. Comment, favorite, share if you think you want to. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Peace out, peeps.